Wow, delicious rambutan from Davao, Tubuk. Hello from Tubuk, people. Hi, everyone. Once again, welcome to my channel, Math is Fun channel. This channel is an educational channel to help all the students out there, all people out there who are struggling in mathematics. And this channel will help you learn about mathematics and to eradicate the misconception that math is a difficult subject. It's not really difficult. It's fun, it's easy, and it's interesting. And this will also help students who are doing the online classes and modular approach to improve your performance in your lessons in mathematics. So this channel is really intended for you. And thank you to those people who are out there who keep on watching the video that we have in my channel. So you make your life more productive because you learn something by watching my video. Please do not forget to watch the video before you subscribe. And in subscribing, please click the yellow bell button so that you will be able to be updated in all my videos or new uploaded videos in my channel. So please, again, do not forget to subscribe my channel, subscribe my videos, and even to share my videos to Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and any other social media or sites. So please support my channel to help the people also, not only in Davao, but also all the people around the world and even outside Davao, in the whole or entire Philippines, okay? So that they will be able to understand what are really the concept of mathematics, that math is a, it's fun and interesting. So I hope you'll be able to share this with your classmates, friends. So now our topic for this video discussion. Are you excited to have a new learning again in this video? Yes, and it's my pleasure to really share my knowledge about mathematics so that everybody will benefit about the concept of mathematics. So to start with, our main objectives in this video discussion is you are expected to state the coordinate of a point on a number line. So we will discuss the number line or integrate the concept of a number line in this topic or video discussion. Another thing also, you're going to graph integers on a number line. And lastly, which is our main focus, though it's part or the three of the objectives are very important, but I want to highlight number three, adding and subtracting integers, because I know that this topic about adding and subtracting of integers, sorry for the inconvenience, we have visitors, dogs. Our dogs are our visitors. They want also to learn mathematics. Again, I would like to highlight the third objective, which is to add and subtract integers, because this is the least learned competency, or most of the students find it difficult to understand this topic. So I hope you'll be able to grasp the concept and understand it in an easy way, in an easy manner rather, or method, or fun method. Okay, so enjoy. Let's have to enjoy, of course. Let's have to focus in here. The number line, as you can see, the number line used to represent the sets of real numbers, or it will help us understand that that the subsets of real numbers. So it has integers, rational, irrational numbers, so on and so forth. So the number line, we all know that, again, that's what I've said, the number line used to represent the sets of real numbers. For integers, we have we have negative numbers, negative 2, negative 1, negative 1, negative, so on and so forth, 0 and 1 and 2, so on and so forth. So we have also have whole numbers, 0, 1, 2. Again, for integers, you have the negative, 0, and positive integers, just to inform you. Okay, whole numbers, we have the 0, it starts in 0, 1, 2, so that's whole numbers. Natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, again, whole numbers are considered as counting numbers, and natural numbers, we have 1, 2, 3. Please do not forget the difference between the two. Whole number starts in 0, natural number starts in 1, so do not forget a 1. Okay, again, I'll repeat, in a number line, as I mentioned, there are numbers that can represent in this. Oh, we have a guest. Okay, say hi, guest. He would like to be recognized. It's my brother, my goodness. Okay, so I would like you to remember about in a number line, there are subsets of real numbers. We have the integers consisting the negative integers, zero and positive integers. And also, we have the whole numbers that will start in zero, one, two, so on and so forth. And natural numbers, lastly, we start it in one, two, three, so on and so forth. So I would like you to really remember that one in a number line so that you will be able to recognize and determine it in or the importance about the number line. So what's the number line again? Used to represent a line that used to represent the subsets of real numbers. Okay. So to graph, a set of numbers means to locate and mark the points on the number line. So that's how we graph the points or the numbers in a number line. A set of numbers means to locate and mark the points on the number line. And this is our definition in the context of a number line in graphing. So, as you can see, if you are going to graph negative 1, 0, and 2, just plot the points. So where? Okay, can you see it? So, of course, you can have the negative 1 in here, 0, and 2 to locate. Again, to graph means a set of numbers means to locate and mark the points on the number line. So you will just plot the points. So this is the graph for negative 1, of course, 0, obviously, and 2. So this is the context of graphing in a number line. So I want you to remember it. Okay? So do not forget the concept in it. Always remember that you have to make sure to put the dots on the line, not above or below. So on the line. So again, your dots must be on the line. Do not forget it in graphing, or else it will be marked wrong by your teacher. So please be careful with that. Okay? Just be careful. It's easy, but you have to be careful. Again, be sure to put the dots on the line, not above or below, on the line. When you graph the numbers or the subsets of real numbers in a number line. Okay? So let's go next. Name that set of numbers graphed. Okay. You're going to name the set of numbers graphed, being graphed there. So you have it there, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 2, what? 6. Correct? So the darkened arrow means that the graph keeps on going. And that's why we ended up with the, what we call that, with ellipsis. What is ellipsis again? In sequence it is, or even in sets, we discuss it, that one, ellipsis. So that's why it is number, it ends in ellipsis, because the graph, as you can see, the darkened arrow means that the graph keeps on going. There is a darkened arrows, as you can, I'll highlight. Look at the arrows, darkened. Okay? That means it's continuous. So meaning to say with that, the darkened arrow means that the graph keeps on going. So when you see this, put three dots in your set, or you call it, again, ellipsis. So let's go over. So use the number line if necessary. Again, use number line. Let's have an example. Use the number line if necessary. So if you have it, okay, we will try to this section, we are going to use the concept of a number line in adding or subtracting of integers. So how do we add them using a number line? So again, it is if it is necessary only. So we have it for y4 negative 4 plus 8. So of course you can even if you don't use a number line, then you can get the answer right away to 4. So 8 minus 4 is equal to 4. Don't worry, I have a separate lesson regarding the number line in adding and subtracting. So in here, negative 1 plus negative 3, that gives you negative 1 minus 3, which is negative 4. Very good. So next, 5 plus negative 7, that is simply means 5 minus 7. And 5 minus 7 is negative 2. So sir, why negative 2? Why not positive? Because 7 is greater than 5. the rule for the for adding or subtracting of integers, you can only add integers if they have the same sign. So if it is positive and positive, then you add. Negative and negative, then you add. And also regarding with the with what sign that will be followed or used when you add integers, as what I have said, and adding integers, you can only add having the same sign and then copy the common sign. So positive and positive is equal to add, then copy positive. So negative and negative is add, then copy the negative sign. And for subtraction, you can only subtract if and only if the numbers have opposite signs, and copy the sign of a bigger number. Please take down note of that. Again, in subtracting, you're going to you can only subtract if you have, or if they have, or if the numbers have opposite signs. Means opposite, they have different signs. So if they have different signs, positive, negative is subtract. Then copy the sign of the bigger number. Negative and positive subtract. Then copy the sign of the bigger number. So if the sign of the bigger number is positive, then copy positive. If the sign of a bigger number is negative, then you copy the negative. Just like in number 3, 5 plus negative 7. So sir, how did you subtract it? Where in fact the operation is plus. Again, change opposite sign. 5 is positive, negative 7 is negative. So 5 and negative 7 are opposite signs. So meaning to say you're going to subtract 5 minus 7. So the answer is 2. So why negative 2, sir? Because 7 is greater than 5. To compare the numbers, do not look at there, or do not include the signs, just the number itself. So 7 and 5, bigger is 7. That's why follow the sign of 7, which is negative. That's the reason why our answer is negative 2. Okay? So going back to the additional rules, that's what I have mentioned or for a while ago. So in additional rule, when the signs are the same, add and keep the sign. See? Another example, negative 2 plus negative 4 is equal to negative 6. Imagine negative 2 and negative 4 have the same sign, which is negative. So just add them 2 plus 4, 6, and then copy the negative sign or their common sign, which is negative. When the signs are different, then subtract and use the sign of the larger number. Oh, see? So negative 2 plus 4, opposite sign, negative 2, and positive 4, opposite sign. So subtract. 4 minus 2 is 2. Why positive, sir? Because 4 is bigger than 2. Easy, right? Example, another thing. 2 plus negative 4. So again, opposite sign, 2 is positive, negative 4 is negative. So subtract 2 minus 4 is 2. Why is it negative 2, sir? Because 4 is bigger than 2. So the answer is negative 2. Very easy, right? Okay, karaoke time, so that you'll be able to remember. Additional rule, sung to the tune. This was taken to the tune of row, row. Row, 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 row your boat. La 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 la. Okay, so let's sing so that you'll be able to remember this one. Same signs, add and keep, different signs, subtract. La 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 la. Keep the sign of the higher number, then it will be exact. Once again, sorry for out of tune. Same signs, add and keep, different signs, subtract. Keep the sign of the higher number, then it will be exact. Wow, that's a great accomplishment for today's video discussion. Same signs, add and keep, different signs, subtract. Keep the sign of the higher number, then it will be exact. Thank you so much for support for my supporters. Feel free to comment. That's how you, so that you'll be able to remember when to add and when to subtract integers. Can your class do different rounds? Maybe in your, while watching this video. So example, negative 1 plus 3. How do you solve that one? Which one is correct? Which one is the answer, rather? The answer is 2y, 3 and negative 1, opposite sign. So subtract 3 minus 1. Then we will take the sign of 3, which is positive. So positive 2. What about this one? Negative 6, negative 6 and negative 3. Both have the same signs. Very good. So add 6 plus 3, 9. Then copy the negative signs. So the answer will be negative 9. Wow! Okay, correct! We're correct! Yes. So, remember about the opposite signs? It will talk about the additive inverses or opposites of two numbers add 2 equals 0. So, it's very important for us to determine the additive inverses of a certain number. Why? Because that gives us the concept of elimination. When we say eliminate, we are going to subtract it. The result is equal to 0. Example, 1. Positive 1, what is the additive inverse of positive 1? That's negative 1. Opposite from the word itself, inverse. Opposites. So opposite of positive is negative. Opposite of negative is positive. So again, what is the additive inverse of positive 2? Negative 2. What is the additive inverse of 5? Negative 5. What is the additive inverse of negative 11? Positive 11. So that's how you do the additive inverse. Because when you combine the additive inverse, the result will be equal to 0. Example, what is the additive inverse of positive 1? Negative 1. So in short, 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. That's the purpose of additive inverse. So another example, what's the additive inverse of negative 3? Positive 3. Correct? So negative 3 plus 3 is equal to 0. Do not forget that concept, additive inverses. So the additive inverse of 3 is what? Negative 3. Very good. What about this one? So proof 3 plus negative 3 is equal to 0. See? Oh, I'm not really lying. That's really a fact. That's the rule. Another, we will use the additive inverses for subtraction problems. So do not forget, when you subtract, always remember about additive inverse. That will really help you. The rule will help you to give you a clue when to subtract integers. Another, what's the difference between 7 minus 3? Between. So 7 minus 3 and 7 plus negative 3 are what? Just the same. 7 minus 3 is equal to 4 and 7 plus negative 3 is equal to 4. See? The same. Please take no note of the form. They will just give you the same answer. So the only difference is that 7 minus 3 is a subtraction problem and 7 plus negative 3 is an addition problem. Wow! This is very, something to make you realize of this lesson. So subtracting is the same as adding the opposite. So take the note, subtracting is the same as adding the opposite. So when subtracting, change the subtraction to adding the opposite or keep change, and then follow your addition rule. So do not forget, read it again. When subtracting, change the subtraction to adding the opposite, keep change, and then follow your addition rule. Let's have an example. Negative 4 minus negative 7, that gives you negative 4 plus 7. So different sign, subtract and use larger sign. So the answer is 3. 7 minus 4 is 3. Copy the sign of 7, which is positive after changing. So another example, negative 3 minus 7. Okay, negative 3 plus negative 7, that gives us what? Same signs. Add and keep the sign. So the answer is negative 10. I hope you got it. So okay, here's one with variable. With a variable. Maybe the next time around. But since I integrated it, we will include this one. So 11b plus 2b, so you have it at and keep the sign, 13b. So let's have an answer, solving a problem, negative 12 minus negative 3, what's the equivalent? Wow, so negative 3 becomes positive 3. So negative 12 plus 3 is what? Okay, correct, negative 12 plus 3. So please do not forget. So 7 minus negative 2. That gives us 7 plus 9, which is positive 9. Wow, very great. So let's have a review before we end up this topic. If the problem is addition, follow your addition rule. If the problem is subtraction, change subtraction to adding the opposite, the keep change, and then follow the addition rule. So the absolute value, I'll just include this one as our part of our lesson. Absolute value of a number is the distance from zero. So any number, any distance from a number to to any of any number from zero, sorry, it's called the absolute value. Again, absolute value of a number is the distance from zero. So distance can never be negative. Imagine your life walking in a distance in an opposite way. Is there a negative? Can you walk in an opposite way? Of course, forward. You cannot walk backward unless, or you will be what? You will be, yeah, that's not good. Okay, so distance can never be negative. Do not forget, absolute value of a number is the distance from zero. So distance can never be negative. The symbol is, as you can see, I'll highlight this one. Symbol, this one, where A is any number. So let's proceed. So let's have an example for absolute value. Don't worry, we're almost done. So the absolute value of 7 is 7. So it's always positive. So the absolute value of A is equal to the absolute value of A is positive and negative A. So meaning to say, whether your A is positive or negative, the result will always be positive. That's the absolute value. Why? Because there is no such distance or negative distance in a number line. It's always positive. So 10, absolute value of 10 is 10. The absolute value of negative 100 is 100. Absolute value of 5 minus 8 is negative 3, which is positive 3. So let's see. 7 minus 2 is? Okay, 5. Very good. Let's try to apply. Okay, 1. And that's it. So do not forget, for the absolute value, it's a distance of any number from zero. So there is no negative distance. So the absolute value of A will always be positive and negative. What I mean, the absolute value of A is positive and negative A. In short, your A must, even if your A is positive or negative, the result of absolute value is positive. Why? Because there is no such negative distance in a number line. That's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Please, if you enjoyed watching this video, please click subscribe and subscribe all. And share my video discussion to your friends and to the people out there. Thank you so much. Continue to watch my video. Have a good day. Have a great day and have a rambutan. It's like cherries. A cherry, rather.